In our previous video, we showed how we define roughness for surface texture analysis. We start with a 2D profile or 3D surface measurement, remove the overall form, then filter out the short and long spatial wavelengths to define the wavelengths we call roughness in our application. Once we have the roughness profile, we can calculate roughness parameters. First, let's look at the 2D case and the R, or roughness parameters. RA is the roughness average, or more commonly, the average roughness. It's the most commonly specified roughness parameter. To calculate RA, we find the best fit mean line, add up the absolute distance from the mean line to each point, and divide by the total number of measured points. Average roughness is typically measured in microns or microinches. That's important. RA has units. You may hear someone talk about an RA of 32. But while an RA of 32 microinches would be typical of a machined surface, an RA of 32 microns would be more like the surface of a brick. Average roughness can provide a general sense of the overall height of surface texture. It can also indicate when a process has changed in some significant way. But RA can't always tell us everything we need to know about a surface. First, it sees heights as absolute values. A 0.1 micron below the mean line will have the same impact on RA as a 0.1 micron above it. If you think your process is producing valleys for lubrication, but it's actually producing peaks, you may not be able to tell from RA alone. Second, average roughness can't tell where features are on the surface. A surface with randomly scattered peaks will have the same RA as a surface with those peaks clustered in one place, and that could lead to scratching, gouging, premature wear, etc. Third, RA can't indicate the spatial wavelengths that comprise the texture, and that could lead to differences in appearance, fluid flow, contact surface, and so on. Before we move on to 3D average roughness, Michigan Metrology has been measuring surfaces for thousands of clients for almost 30 years now. Visit MitchMet.com to learn how we can help you with your 3D surface texture measurements, and to check out all of our surface texture-related reference materials. Now, let's talk about areal, or 3D texture. SA is the areal, 3D, average roughness. SA is calculated similarly to RA. We remove the overall shape, calculate a mean plane, filter out the short and long wavelengths, measure the absolute distance from each point to the plane, then average all the distances for the SL surface. While RA and SA are both average roughness, they are not equivalent. By definition, RA is derived from 2D data, and SA is calculated over an area. So, can we calculate RA from 3D data? Most 3D software provides tools that let you draw a 2D trace through the data and calculate RA over that profile. However, it's difficult to select the exact same trace through the data more than once, so you may get different RA values every time. Some 3D analysis software includes stylus XRA and stylus YRA parameters. As we talk about in our blog, these parameters are not equivalent to RA or SA. Because they are calculated over many 2D traces, they will almost always give different values than RA. And because we level the mean heights for each trace and calculate the deviations in only one direction, they also aren't equivalent to SA. But they do let us filter out a dominant structure in one axis in order to see smaller roughness features in the other direction. Michigan Metrology provides 3D surface roughness measurement to help manufacturers understand the surface texture of their components. Find out how we can help you with your surface texture measurement needs.